The Lost Book of Xandar, inspired by the Divine Lord, written by his humble servant Xandar, discovered by the brilliant YouTuber eddygoombah. Chapter G58B, Subset H. And so, on the eighth day, the Lord said unto Adam,
Come hither, so that I mayest counsel thee on what is to come.
And Adam, who had busied himself with naming the creatures and test-driving said animals, said,
Gnarly dude, what's up?
And the Lord regretted making Adam as a teenager and wondered if he would ever understand this younger generation.
Hark ye unto my words, said the Lord. I mean, listen up, yo, he corrected himself. I hast made thee in mine own image and have blessed thee with eternal life, so that thou mayest commune with me throughout eternity here in the paradise I hast created for you. All thee must do is praise me, thine creator, and hearken unto me when I beckonest thee.
Adam, perplexed as much by the concept of forever as he was with the concept of death, tilted his head sideways and asked,
Huh?
The Lord, perturbed by his creation's lack of understanding, destroyed three stars in the heavens, creating the Crab, Horsehead, and Keyhole Nebulas. Satisfied that his temper tantrum had subsided, he turned back to Adam and said,
Have you seen Highlander? The first one, not the second one that didn't make any sense. Oh, right, sorry. Where were you before you were here with me?
Adam shrugged his shoulders and scratched his balls.
Before I made thee, I had existed forever, and exist forever hence, I shall still.
Adam started looking around for a fluffy animal he had previously named a sheep, and was bored by the words of the Lord.
See thee how the sun moves across the sky, and the day and the night are separated? That is called time. Imagine as many animals as you have named since yesterday. The camel, the gull, the coelacanth, Darwin's finches, Acherontia atropos.
Sheep?
Inquired Adam.
Yes, and the damn sheep,
said the Lord with a huff.
Pick up a handful of sand, Adam.
Adam did, and it immediately stuck to his suntan lotion and began to chafe.
Count thee the grains of sand, and still eternity you will not fathom, said the Lord,
setting the stage for the inspiration for a little green Martian with a flaming sword thousands of years later. Again, Adam had no clue what the Lord was talking about, but he nodded his head and continued to act as though he was not thinking about the sheep.
Are you thinking about the sheep again, Adam? The Lord asked.
Well, yeah, see, you told me to give him a test drive so that I could find one that could keep me comfortable on chilly days and help me with those urges you gave me. And so far, the sheep's in the lead.
Adam, that is not what I intended, and you should not be putting your body parts into the sheep's orifices.
Why not?
Because it's wrong.
What's that?
What's what?
What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
What?
I'm fine. I am the Lord.
Okay, so what was that about the sheep?
To lie with a sheep is an abomination and wrong.
I'm lost, Adam said.
You are in the Garden of Eden, the paradise on earth that I have created for you.
I mean the sheep thing.
Damn it, Adam, there are things that you can do and things you cannot do. Those things that are good and wholesome, you are allowed to do. And those things that are bad and evil, you are not allowed to do.
Oh, good and evil. Kind of like that tree over there.
And the Lord facepalmed at his own stupidity and nodded slowly, realizing that he may have made a mistake 8 days ago. But luckily, he would see that he'd have many opportunities to right this wrong later on down the road.
Yes, like that tree over there.
Adam looked over at the tree and thought it might make a great treehouse. So he walked over to it and looked up through the branches. As he peered at the sun twinkling through the leaves, a fruit of the tree fell from the branch and smacked him on the head.
Ow! Dude, what the fuck? Ah! How did that happen?
And the Lord was displeased by Adam's profanity, but quickly realized that he couldn't say anything about it due to his own rules.
That was a fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, my son.
Well, no shit. I mean, why did it hit me in the face?
And thus saith the Lord,
tide goes in, tide goes out. Never a miscommunication.
What the hell does that mean?
Adam said, rubbing the bits of mushy fruit from his forehead. The Lord then sat upon a rock and explained to Adam that this world, the Lord's creation, had been perfectly made for Adam. The Lord's lecture was interrupted many times as a wasp stung Adam on the arm, leeches attached themselves to his calves, birds flew and sang above him and shit directly on him, and at one point, a sheep walked by, and Adam began to touch himself in a stimulating manner. Once the Lord had finished his speech and tended to Adam's wounds and found a few fig leaves with which Adam could clean both the bird shit and his seed, he proceeded up onto his throne in heaven and contemplated what he had done. Adam, in the meantime, found that as the sun setteth, the cold did set his bones to a chill, and he walked through the garden in search of something warm and cuddly.